Hi, I'm Mark Farber. This is Accounting Fundamentals Videos. What we want to do in this video is take a look at T accounts and the dreaded debits and credits. So we're going to start to talk accounting, so to speak. And a lot of students have difficulty with this, so you want to kind of take care that you understand it, because as we move forward, this is the language that we're going to use as we talk about all of our accounting. So a T account, to jump right into it, is nothing more than a means of keeping track of the amounts that are kept in a particular account. Called a T account, obviously, because it's in the shape of a T. And if we go over and we take a look at our T account over here, what we'll see is that it has two sides. And they have very technical names. This side over here is called the left side of the account. And this side over here, you guessed it, is the right side of the account. But they also have different names. And in accounting, we refer to the left side as the debit side, which we often abbreviate as DR, which is Latin for something. And on the right side, we call that the credit side, which is abbreviated CR, which is nothing more than short form for credit. What does that all mean? Well, what it means is we have one side for keeping track of increases in an account and the other side for keeping track of decreases in an account. So why don't we just call it the plus side and the minus side? Well, that's the trick in accounting. You see, which side is the increase and which side is the decrease depends on the account. So let's go back to our accounting equation over here. And what I can do is I can, and I'll just put this in like this, I can turn that into a little t. And what you'll see is that on this side of the t, the asset side, is the debit side. The liability and equity side of the equation is the credit side. So assets are referred to as debit accounts. And what that means is that when we debit an asset, or if we wish to increase an asset, we debit it. So a debit on the asset side, DR, equals plus. The credit accounts over here, liabilities and equity, work exactly the opposite way. I told you this gets confusing. So when we want to increase a liability or increase an equity account, we credit it. So on this side, a credit equals a plus. And the opposite holds true. So a credit to an asset is a minus. So if I want to decrease cash, I would credit cash. If I wanted to decrease the amount of equipment I had, I would credit equipment. And a debit over here is a minus. So if I increase a bank loan is liability. If I want to increase it, I would credit the bank loan. If I want to decrease it, I would debit the bank loan. Well, why do we do all of that? Well, there's another simple truth that holds in accounting, and that's this. Every time we do an account, the debits have to equal the credits. And so this becomes a really useful way of keeping track of, as we record transactions, is our accounting equation in balance. After all, if my debits equals my credits, well, if I increased an asset, I debited it, and I increased a liability, I credited it, the debit would equal the credit, and I'd have a plus on both sides of the equation. Similarly, if I increased an asset, so I debited it, and I decreased another asset, i.e. credited it, my debit would equal my credit, and everything would hold. So this is a very simplified way of making sure that every time we do a transaction, that our accounting equation is going to remain in balance without us having to go back and check it. All we have to know is that the debits equal the credits. Okay, and this is referred to as double entry accounting, meaning that every entry that we do, every time we record a transaction, there's going to be a debit, at least one debit and one credit. There can be more, and we'll see that later on. But if you think back to our last video where we looked at some transactions, cash went up when we had an investment, and capital went up. And now, instead of talking about pluses and minuses, what we're going to do is we're going to start to use debits and credits to denote when something goes up and when something goes down. Okay. In our next video, what we'll do is we'll actually start to look at some transactions, and this time we're going to record them using debits and credits. So really important to get this under control in your head, and we'll go from there.